שלום עליכם רבותיי, שלום עליכם, בעזרת השם נמיד את הצדיק הרבי חיים פינטו, נמיד את my grandfather, רבי משה אהרון פינטו, מהקדוש ברוך הוא, בעזרת השם, גיבל מביק ברכה והצלחה, בסייעתא דשמיא הגדולה, מהקדל מוי וחתקון ויזקתקון, ונמיד את עוד הצדיקים מהקדוש ברוך הוא, נגיד את הפנסה, נגיד את השואה, נגיד את הזיווג, נגיד את המזל, נגיד את התשובה, מהקדוש ברוך הוא, spill on each and every one of our קהילה, שפע עד בלידי, may all our prayers be heard ברצון, מהקדוש ברוך הוא, fulfill all our wishes, אמן, כן יהי רצון בעזרת השם. Like every Tuesday, it's a very special day because it is the day of Torah. It's the day of Tiferet. We say that a person could achieve big bracha by connecting to the Torah, by strengthening the emunah, by doing an extra mitzvah, by spreading Torah, and etc. Why? Because in this day, the koach of the Torah is active on Tuesday. And in Rabotei, right now, we are mamash a few days after Shavuot, a few days after the beginning of the new Torahic year. We can all sit down about it and think to ourselves, what can we possibly do? How can we possibly act that in the upcoming Torahic year, we will really be able to receive Shefa, to receive Bracha, to grow spiritually, but also to grow our mazal, to grow what we're meant to receive, to grow what our potential is to receive, and to really just be connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in a way where we will receive Shefa and we'll be able to give Shefa, but in comfort. And the real question is, how can we put ourselves in that position? How can we make ourselves not only a vessel to receive bracha, Torah, Shefa, but also how can we grow ourselves as a vessel to give back to HaKadosh Baruch Hu? And this is where I would like to bring a beautiful Zohar HaKadosh, Parashat Bamidbar, page Kuf Samech Vav. It's a beautiful Zohar that it's essentially a very emotional moment that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai praises the Torah and praises HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It says in the Zohar that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was sitting down on the road. And he looked up to the sky and he started to praise HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to praise the teachings of the Torah. And it says that the Zohar HaKadosh says that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai looked at the sky and he said, Torah, Torah, you are such a beautiful creation. Torah, Torah, this entire world stands on you and the entire Olamot HaElyonim, higher worlds, stand on you like a pillar. Torah, Torah, you give light and life to all of them. That without you, there would be no creation, there would be no existence. Torah, Torah, you are the most beautiful creation in the world, that there is secrets that are hidden to be unveiled just by putting effort and just by looking deeper into you. Torah, Torah, please open my heart to be able to spill Shefa and to bring down your secrets to the world. Then the Zohar HaKadosh says, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai got up, put his head in the afar, in the dirt, in the ash, kissed the ash and he started to cry. He was kissing the dirt that's on the roads and he was crying and crying and crying while he was kissing the dirt. Now, but this entire Zohar has a lot of place for interpretation and for explanation. Why did Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, after praising the Torah and after asking HaKadosh Baruch Hu so much for being able to bring down secrets, why did he kiss the dirt? We know that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was not a regular person. Every single act that he did, there was a reason behind it. So what is this after he praises HaKadosh Baruch Hu, after asks Hashem to open Razet Torah, to open the secrets of Torah, he kisses the dirt. Now we have to understand Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was a tzaddik. He was dependent solely on what HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives him. It's not like any posek halacha that he opens up the books and he looks at other halachot and he builds an halacha of that. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, all his Torah was based on what Hashem gives him. So what is the explanation of this kissing of the ground? So in Abu Tayyim, the Zohar HaKadosh explains something incredible. And this is actually the trick in the creating a vessel to receive from above. There is one attribute that the Zohar HaKadosh says that is the utmost important in order to really receive Torah, to receive Shefa, to receive Bach. What attribute are we talking about? The Zohar HaKadosh says, Midat ha'anava, the attribute of humility. That the attribute of humility is the keli for a person to come close to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and for HaKadosh Baruch Hu to take steps to come closer to the person and to receive Torah, to receive Shefa, and to receive abundance. And that's something that we can learn from Avraham Avinu. But what do we learn from Avraham Avinu? Avraham Avinu looked up to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and he said, Are ani ka'afa da'ara. Me, in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I am like the dirt that is the ash that sits on the ground. The Zohar Kosh Rabotai wants to teach us something incredible. If a person wants to reach to great heights and to be one with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, what must he do? He must put himself in complete humility. He needs to do like what Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai did. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, what did he do? He praised the dirt more than he praised himself. Because the fact that he kissed the dirt, the fact that he put himself in that place of kissing and crying on the dirt, it was like a sign of even the dirt is higher than me. And that's how he was able to reach to such high levels of Torah, bringing down the entire Zohar HaKadosh. It wasn't the fact that he was considering himself to be something big. It was the exact opposite, where he took dirt and he made even dirt at a higher percentage in him. And that's what we say about Moshe Rabbeinu. We say, Moshe Rabbeinu, how did he reach to be considered to be Aisha Elokim? Isha Elokim is godly man, if we translate it. How did Moshe Rabbeinu reach to the level of being a godly man that went up to the sky, a godly man that brought down the Torah, a godly man that fought angels? Zohar Kosh is not the Zohar, all the Mefashim. It says it's simple. V'Moshe Anav Mikol Adam. What was Moshe's secret? The fact that he was the most humble man that ever existed in the entire world. Once we cancel ourselves and we put ourselves a step back, we leave room for Hashem to come in and to fill that void. And that's what Rabbi Chaim Mivolozhin says. Rabbi Chaim Mivolozhin says, the more a person makes himself small in the eyes of Hashem, the more his vessel becomes big to receive. But you would think opposite. You would think if you make yourself big and you act with pride and you show the whole world who you are and what you're capable of and all these things to make yourself big, you would think that only then your vessel is bigger. But Rabbi Chaim Mivolozhin says no. The smaller you become, the more room there is in your vessel. That now your vessel has more space for Hashem to bless you with more blessings and with more good things. And that, Rabotai, is the trick. The trick is the smaller that we make ourselves, that's how we can reach to high levels. And this, Rabotai, could be with anything. It could be with Shalom Bayit. It could be at work. It could be between two friends. It could be even with ourselves. But sometimes we have this battle with ourselves that we think that we need to uphold ourselves at a high place in order for others to respect us, for others. Rabotai, that is all shtiyot. If we want Be'acha, we need Rabotai to act in the exact same way that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai acted. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai acted in what way? He acted in a way of anava, of humility, and as a result, he reached to high levels. You know, Rabotai, maybe we can say that's also the reason that it said even in Tehillim. What did it say there? In Tehillim, in Tfilat Shmona Esrei, it says that, it says simple, I am like dirt in front of all creations, betach libi betoatecha. Right afterwards, after we said Pasuk, that I am like dirt in front of all your creations, we say, open my heart for your Torah. The only way we can really receive Shefa from above is by Limud Torah. Rabotai, that's what we have to act today. We need to find a way, Rabotai, to put our heads down, to make ourselves smaller in the eyes of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to make ourselves smaller in the eyes of the world, and as a result, we receive big Be'acha. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Rabotai, he set up the whole world in a way, unfortunately, that it's very easy to be humble. You know all what's happening in the world. It's so humbling to see that man thought that we were so powerful. We thought that we have so much control, and we see that everything that's happening. I don't even want to get into details that's happening around the world. It is showing us how much we have no control. How much HaKadosh Baruch Hu controls everything. So if HaKadosh Baruch Hu already controls everything, and we're already such small creations in such a big world, then maybe we should at least receive bracha by living in that reality. And the only way we can receive bracha from that reality is if we accept and we submit ourselves to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And that's what we have to do. We have to look at ourselves, Rabotai, and we have to say, Arei ani ka'afra da'arad, in front of the eyes of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We are nothing in front of the eyes of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And as a result, we receive bracha, we receive shefa, we receive panasa, we receive Bat Hashem Torah. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Bat Hashem, will open up all the gates. Our emunah will become stronger. HaKadosh Baruch Hu will guide us because we will be more dependent on Him. And as a result, Rabotai, we will live lives full of bracha, atzlacha, v'siyata d'shmayim, and only good things. And that's what we can learn, Rabotai, throughout our entire Torah. That's what we can learn from the Zohar HaKadosh. The Zohar HaKadosh, Rabotai, was written where? It was written in a cave. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, he put himself in dirt. He buried himself in dirt. He considered himself to be under the dirt. As a result, HaKadosh Baruch Hu opened up Razei Torah. He became Be'emet Ha'isha Elokim. If we want to reach to high level, Rabotai, that's what we have to do. So may HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us all bracha v'atzlacha. May we succeed in this quest of making ourselves small in the eyes of HaKadosh Baruch Hu in order to grow our vessel to receive more and more abundance from Hashem. יום טוב מבורך, עם פיק ברכה והצלחה מן קניית, בעזרת השם.